Now, ladies, can I ask you please to refrain from throwing underwear on the stage for our next guest? Okay. Our next recipient has had international success as part of a famous boy band that to date has sold over 15 million records. He's also appeared on the first ever Celebrity Big Brother and came third. In 2003, he joined the cast of Coronation Street as barman Kieran McCarthy and enjoyed a healthy stay and a turbulent time on the street. Keith returned to the stage, this time to act and starred in Dandelions, which was a fantastic success. He is known for his huge commitment to the charity, in particular one very close to his own heart, Autism in Ireland. He has literally just come off stage at the MEN Arena. Ladies and gentlemen, from Boyzone, Keith Duffy.
Good evening.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are you?
firstly, I'd like to congratulate Brendan O'Carroll and his gang. I love your work, Brendan. Brendan's hired me a few times. I've been in a few of the DVDs, and it's great to work with him. I'm delighted to see that your work has been repaid and honoured like it is tonight, Brendan. You deserve that and everything else, and the whole team. I don't know if you understood that, but Brendan has his whole family on tour with him, his whole family on stage with him, and it's a fantastic, fantastic thing to do, I think, you know, because when you're touring around, the people that you miss most are your family, and to be given an opportunity that Brendan has to have his family with him is fantastic, and well done, and long may it rain for you, Brendan. apart from, you know, my career, I'd like to kind of thank basically for giving me this award, but giving me the opportunity to explain to you why it is I believe I got this award. About 6 years ago, myself and my wife were worried about our little daughter. She wasn't responding the way most children are supposed to. And we kind of thought initially that she might have a hearing problem. And having had her hearing tested, we realized then that our hearing was fine and that it was obviously a different problem that we had to face. So, as you can imagine, we were very, very concerned and worried. Autism was mentioned, and I didn't really know an awful lot about it at the time, so I had to kind of educate myself on that and firstly find out, you know, is it autism, so to get a diagnostic report done. Until I met with so many different obstacles, trying to get a diagnostic report done in Ireland was impossible at the time. There was a waiting list of maybe 16 to 24 months. But yet anybody, any professional that I spoke to said that early intervention with children for autism is essential for their future. But how can you avail of the services if you can't get a diagnosis? And if you're waiting 2.5 years for a diagnosis, obviously that's going to take away whatever chance you have to give your children the chance in life that most children get for free. So to be honest with you, to kind of take myself out of a depression or out of a state that I didn't know how to deal with, I decided to throw myself into educating myself, number one, on autism, and then finding out exactly what it is that these children needed, and then try to provide that for the children. I found this form of education called ABA, Applied Behavioral Analysis. Going back, you know, 5 or 6 years, the basic traits that my daughter had at the time was that she was kind of living in her own world. It was very sad. She kind of, you know, to be honest with you, any time we brought her outside the house, she'd put a blanket over her head. She didn't have much communication. She didn't have any language. She didn't speak to us. And it was a very, very upsetting time. I don't want to go on a negative, but these are the types of things that you expect with children with autism. If I hadn't known or educated myself any better, I would have probably just done what I was told. But I knew from speaking to people that there was an education out there that would, you know, help my daughter and other children like her to have a more fulfilled life.
So we campaigned and we opened up a school that taught ABA. And the reason that it's not readily available is that it is expensive. Children with autism need a one-to-one teaching process. Every child needs their own teacher. Now, this will only be needed, really, if you get the right window of opportunity for 3 or 4 years. And then these children can be, you know, entertained or basically integrated into mainstream school or even a special needs school, which is a start. So we were very fortunate to get a school open. We had 6 kids, we had 6 tutors in the school. Obviously every child had their own tutor. Shooting 5 years forward, we've now got 12 schools open. Most of the schools have over 30 children in each school. We've got a waiting list of about, there's about 12 schools on a waiting list to be opened. And then to take away the problem of the diagnosis, we fundraised over the space of 3 years and we opened up our very own diagnostic report centre in Dublin. And to date now, we're 18 months open and we've diagnosed over 320 children. So, thank you. The positive side I want to tell you, just to give you a kind of an idea of why a child with autism might need a one-to-one teaching process. Children with autism have heightened sensories. For example, I mean, you can sit down there and listen to what I have to say to you tonight, but there's always distracting noises surrounding us, whether it be glasses, people chatting, whatever. I mean, it's quite quiet in here tonight, but in an ordinary classroom setting, there are distracting noises, the traffic going by outside and so forth. These children hear all those noises amplified at the same volume, and this takes away their concentration level to be able to understand what a teacher is trying to teach. So they end up cutting their hands over their ears and going into their own little world. So to get them teaching on a one-to-one level with eye contact constantly and basically reinforcing all the positive play that they have, it helps them to move forward and to learn. It helps them to have the tools that they need to be able to survive in a classroom setting, in a mainstream setting. My little girl Mia, who I'm delighted to say is here with me tonight, and my son Jay as well, they're sitting down the back with my wife, which, to be honest, we've just played the MEN tonight. It was absolutely fantastic. It was great to be back in Manchester, but to play to a crowd of that volume and everything, it was amazing. Sorry you missed it, actually, but we're on again tomorrow night. But Mia now, it's kind of like a miracle story, you know, from a girl that was so distant to us. And Jay, my son, he'd say to me, you know, Dad, why does my sister not speak to me, you know? And to give you a positive view on that, now he says to me, Dad, how do we shut her up? So that will give you an idea how this schooling works and how successful that it actually is. Mia started mainstream school in September of last year with a special needs assistant in the classroom. 3 months in, we got a phone call from the school to say, listen, we really think that the special needs assistant is not needed anymore. This is a miracle from where we started. And you know, to hear that come back from the teacher is amazing. And to be honest, the worst day of my life was when I got that diagnosis, because whatever happens to me, I'll deal with it. Whatever happens, you know, when it's your children and you're responsible for them, and you kind of think that all the dreams that you had for them might be gone. To get this opportunity for my daughter to start in mainstream school, to be given a fair chance, and not only that, in a few weeks ago, in May just gone, it just so happened that she had progressed in enough time to start mainstream school in second class. And in second class, all the kids make their first Holy Communion. And to see her in a little white dress a few weeks ago making her first Holy Communion with peer equal children, I have to say, was most probably the best day of my life. And like I said, the timing of this evening has been great, because we just happened to be in Manchester, and my wife and children have flown in for the day and they're here tonight, which is great. And all I'd like to say is, now on that note, is thank you very, very much for this. I really do appreciate it. I'm going to be a bit of a Bob Geldof on it, and basically dedicate it to the children that have succeeded in the appropriate education, and for those children who need it and can't avail of it, this is for them. Thank you very, very much.
What a man. Keith Duffy, straight from the stage of the MEN Arena.